Hello students, welcome to standard 10 subject mathematics. This is lecture number 2 in chapter number polynomials. Chapter number 2 polynomials. Now we will see the geometrical meaning of zero of the polynomial. Zero of the polynomial we have seen in last lecture how to find. Now geometrically how it means and how to represent and what from where we have to find out zero, that we will understand here. So consider first the linear polynomial. For linear polynomial we will understand the geometrical meaning of zeros of polynomial. As you know that a linear polynomial is ax plus b type of form where a is not equal to 0. And we know that graph of y equal to ax plus b, if we draw the graph of y equal to ax plus b, that is linear polynomial, is a straight line. Graph of linear polynomial is a straight line that we know. And here we will confirm also, by example we will see. The graph of y equal to 2x plus 3, one of the linear polynomials for example is taken, and we are going to draw this linear polynomials graph by taking y equal to 2x plus 3 as an equation. It is a straight line, you will see, passing through the points 0, 3 and minus 3 by 2, 0. From where these two points comes, as in 9th standard also you have drawn the graphs, recall that. For this y equal to 2x plus 3, if you want to draw the graph, what we do? First we take x equal to 0 in this. So y equal to 2 into 0 plus 3. 2 into 0 will be 0 plus 3. 0 plus 3 is 3. So x equal to 0, then y equal to 3. So this first point comes 0, 3. Now next point we take y equal to 0. If we take y equal to 0 in this equation, this will be 0, y equal to 0, equal to 2x plus 3 as it is. Now here, plus 3 we take here, minus 3, equal to 2x. So what will be x equals to minus 3, this 2 will be down, so minus 3 by 2. So the second point is x equal to minus 3 by 2 and y equal to 0. So minus 3 by 2 and 0. These two values, pair of values of x and y, we will place on a bracket in our table. When x equal to 0, y equal to 3 we got here. And when x equal to, then when y equal to 0, x equal to minus 3 by 2 we got. Now using these two pairs of the coordinates, we will plot that points on the graph. As you know that x axis is drawn this way, horizontal. We say x dash is x axis and y dash is y axis. On this, the first point is 0, 3, 0, 3. So 0 on x axis here it will be and 3 on y axis here it will be. So this point is called 0, 3. Next point, minus 3 by 2 and 0. So minus 3 by 2 on x axis will be, minus 3 by 2 means 0, minus 3 by 2 in decimal form, minus it will be 1.5. 1.5 is the midpoint of 1 and 2, minus 1 and 2. So midpoint of minus 1 and minus 2 is this. This is the point minus 3 by 2 and 0 means no height at down we have to go. This is only the point minus 3 by 2, 0. So this is the second point, this is the first point, 0, 3, this is the second point. Now joining these two points, you draw a curve. So you will find that when you joining these two points, you will find a straight line. So this way we have seen that for the linear polynomial related graph will be always a straight line. Now we will find out the zero of this example linear polynomial. Here zero of the given polynomial is minus 3 by 2. Why? And in previous lecture we have seen how to find zero. To find zero, let's px equals to this y equal to px, suppose the polynomial px equal to 2x plus 3. So k is called 0, the real number k is called 0 when k is replaced by, sorry, x is replaced by k and pk equal to 0, that way we will find it. So by taking that, replacing x by k, pk equals to here 2k plus 3 and equal to 0 you will take to find 0. So therefore k equals to plus 3 will be that side, minus 3 and 2 will be down. So k equal to minus 3 by 2. as bk equal to 0 we have taken, and the value of k is minus 3 by 2. So this k equal to minus 3 by 2 is called 0 of the given polynomial. So here we have that 0 of the given polynomial is minus 3 by 2. By calculating this way, by theory, in my last lecture we have seen, we are finding that 0 of the polynomial is minus 3 by 2. And in graph what we are finding, and the graph of y equal to 2x plus 3, this graph intersect this graph of this line, y equal to 2x plus 3 is this line, the graph is this line. It is intersecting the x-axis, at which point? At this point, minus 3 by 2 and 0. At minus 3 by 2 and 0. This minus 3 by 2, 0 is on x-axis, and this minus 3 by 2 is the 0 of the polynomial also. So there is a relation. What is the relation? Thus, the 0 of the polynomial ax equal to x plus 3, as you know, minus 3 by 2, is the x coordinate of the point where the graph of y equal to x plus 3 intersects the x-axis. What is this minus 3 by 2? It is a 0 of the polynomial. And where we are finding on geometrical representation on graph, this minus 3 by 2 is the intersection point of the graph of the given polynomial and x-axis. And in that minus 3 by 2 is x coordinate of this intersection point. So that's the point here, the 0 of the polynomial px equal to 2x plus 3 is the x coordinate. This is x coordinate of the point where the graph of y equal to 2x plus 3 intersects the x-axis. This point is the intersection point of graph and x-axis. And on this point, x coordinate is minus 3 by 2. So this x coordinate of the intersection point is called the 0 of the polynomial, because it is minus 3 by 2 and by calculation also minus 3 by 2. This is the conclusion we reach. So in general, what you can say, for a linear polynomial ax plus b, where a is not equal to 0, the graph of y equal to ax plus b is always a straight line, that you know, and which intersects the x-axis. It will be the straight line and it will intersect the x-axis, like here. It is a straight line of the linear polynomial graph, and it is intersecting the x-axis. Intersect the x-axis at exactly one point only. The line will intersect x-axis at exactly one point only, and that point will be minus b upon a 0 time. Minus b upon a 0 time, because the 0 of ax plus b will be minus b upon a, that we have seen in last lecture also. So 0 of the linear or any actually polynomial is always the intersection point of the graph and the x-axis. Therefore, the linear polynomial, next about the linear polynomial. The linear polynomial ax plus b, a not equal to 0, has exactly 1 0, because it will intersect the x-axis at only one point. So exactly 1 0 it will have. Linear polynomial always has only 1 0, and that will be the x-coordinate of the point where the graph of y equal to ax plus b intersects the x-axis. And what will be that 0 geometrically? That 0 geometrically will be, this is the x-coordinate of the intersection point of graph and x-axis. So where we have to focus on the intersection point, intersection of which two? Of the given graph and x-axis. The graph where it intersects the x-axis, that point we have to see, and from that point we have to find x-coordinate, and this x-coordinate will be the 0 of the given polynomial. This is the conclusion. This is about all linear polynomial we have discussed. Now for any quadratic polynomial, as you know, ax square plus bx plus c standard form is e not equal to 0. The graph of corresponding equation, if we draw the graph of this quadratic also, y equal to x plus bx square plus bx plus c, so has one of the two shapes. It will have one of the two shapes. Like in linear, we are having the shape as straight line. In quadratic, which shape you will get? Any one of the two shapes you will get, either open upwards means this way the graph will be. The graph you draw, the graph will be like this way, open upwards side. it is shown open upwards, open on upward side, or open downwards, or open downward means the graph may be like this, so you will get quadratic polynomial. Like this means open downwards. Depending on whether a is greater than 0 or a is less than 0. So you understand that if a is greater than 0, you will get the shape of the graph as open upwards for this quadratic polynomial. And if a is less than 0, if this a is less than 0 minus number, then the graph, then you draw the quadratic polynomial corresponding equation, that graph shape will be open downwards, this type of shape you will get. Now these shapes, upward, open upwards or open downwards, these curves, this type of curves are called parabolas. Remember for one more question in India, what is the shape of the graph when you draw the graph of parabola, the graph of quadratic polynomial? So it will be always parabola. What is parabola? It will be the shape of open upwards like this or open downwards like this. Which type of shapes are called parabola shapes? Here also it is true, what is true, that the zero of any quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, a not equal to 0, are precisely the x coordinate of the points where the parabola representing y equal to ax square plus bx plus c intersect the x-axis. Means whether it is linear polynomial or whether it is quadratic polynomial or whether it is any type of polynomial, what is the zero of the polynomial? What is the zero of the polynomial? Zero of the polynomial will be always geometrically, it will be always the x coordinate of the intersection point of the graph and the x-axis. This is the general thing that we have to understand from these two, linear polynomial and quadratic polynomial. This was cubic polynomial also and any type of polynomial to find. And what is the geometrical meaning of the zero of a polynomial? The zero of the polynomial will be always the x-coordinate of the intersection point of x-coordinate of the intersection point of which two things? The graph of the given linear or quadratic or cubic or any other polynomial and x-axis. The intersection point of x-axis and the graph we have to see, and in that we have to see the x-coordinate. That x-coordinate will give us the zero of the polynomial.